The high school football season kicks off for many area schools today, but one school in particular has already stolen the spotlight. Lindsay Murphy joins us now with the story. Lindsay.
Sean, I'm sure you've heard the saying, it's not the size of the dog. Okay, I knew I was going to mix this up. It's not the size of the dog in the fight, rather the size of the fight in the dog. That should be the motto of Friendship Collegiate Academy. It's a school that flies a bit under the radar despite being one of the toughest competitors in our area.
It's Washington, D.C. against Ohio, next on the U.
The lights, camera, and action of a nationally televised football game wasn't too much to bear for a small charter school in Northeast named Friendship Collegiate Academy.
And he loses the football.
Last week in Cincinnati, Ohio, the Knights defeated Taft 12-6 on ESPNU.
Double coverage, what an interception!
Despite 15 penalties, which cost them 85 yards.
Shot block.
You always learn a lot more from adversity than you will with just success. So I think it's going to make us a better team. If we went out there and kind of blew the team out, I think we may have came back with our head up in the sky like we were someone, but we struggled through that game.
Defensive lineman Eddie Goldman has a lot to do with the game being televised. He is one of the top five recruits in the country. At 6'4", 300 pounds, he can pretty much choose where he wants to play next season, possibly Maryland, Miami, or Alabama.
It's just nothing but opportunity. You know, I don't get, big-headed or it doesn't, hype me. I just think of it as I got an opportunity.
Eddie helps you as a coach where people think you're a better coach than what you are. You know, the stuff that he brings to the table, you really can't teach.
Friendship Collegiate stole the national spotlight. They also have one of the top recruits in the country. The one thing they can't brag about, their practice facilities and Friendship Beach. But it doesn't seem to affect any of these football players.
Trips left, H left, go back.
Some of us, this we've been going through our whole life, so it's just a norm for us. We're doing what we love, so wherever I can play football at, that's where I'm gonna play it at, no matter where it's at. Turf, grass, dirt, anywhere.
In our locker room, we're not worried about a locker room. We just worried about going out on the field and playing our game.
It's obvious the practice field is less than ideal, but imagine having no home stadium for games, no league to play in, and a locker room that is a mobile storage unit. In its eighth year, this charter school is making moves on the national scene while quietly struggling behind the scenes.
It's not too many places in this city where 130 African-American young males, especially in 13 to 18, are doing something positive all at one time.
Don't expect to hear complaints from the Knights, who are making the most of their situation. After a 7-4 season last year, they are ranked number 10 in the Washington Post this season.
Now, last year, the school had 14 students sign letters of intent to play football. This year, Friendship Collegiate already has a 2-0 record after beating Mount St. Joseph's last night, 18-13. Friendship Collegiate is one of the choices for the Fox 5 High School Football Game of the Week. Remember to cast your vote. Text your school name or number 29473. Remember, standard messaging rates do apply. You can always vote on myfoxdc.com. The polls close noon on Thursday.
What a great group of young men.
Incredible.
I mean, it's no fun to play in dirt at all. I mean, it just shows you don't need turf, you don't need this to achieve what they've achieved.
And they're making
great
the most
attitudes.
Of what they have.
That's why I said it's not the size of the dog in the fight, because it's a pretty small school. These guys are just doing what they can do with what they've been given.
Yep.
They have a lot
to be proud
of.
Absolutely.
I wish them well. Thank you, Lindsay Murphy.
Thanks.